welcome. All right, I'm gonna straight up say it. Look, if you can grasp what I'm about to talk about and these concepts that I'm talking about, this should absolutely be life-changing. It should make your life a lot easier to live, okay? It's gonna be a lot of stuff that you gotta learn. That's any time in life. But specifically with this subject, I feel like this is the most important stuff that people need to know in order to obtain what I would call true freedom. So I'm giving y'all this in a diluted, simplified way for you all to just get the ball rolling and in order for you to get your mind around what's going on. But look, let me just straight up ask you this. Have you ever heard that we have the natural right to bear arms? Like, we have the right to bear arms, right? Okay, cool. But then at the same time, you hear people say that you have to have a permit in order to carry a concealed weapon. So it's like, how is it both? All right, just think about that for a second. Let me explain something to you real quick. There is a huge difference between the United States of America, the place, and the United States, which is a corporation, okay? So you all have to be able to comprehend this. The United States is a corporation. So look, I'm gonna pick up my Black's Law Dictionary, right? This is the biggest version. You all could definitely get a pocket pad version, but this is what you need to know. You have to understand how law works. You have to overstand how law works. Okay, so you have to, first of all, know what the laws are in order to know what your rights are as a person. Okay, so first of all, we want to ask ourselves, what is a corporation? Okay, so right here in the law dictionary, because mind you, these law terms are not the same thing as what everyday people use a lot of the time. Okay, so you don't even know what a lot of these words really mean legally, quote unquote. So knowing that, that's why I think it's so important to get a law dictionary. In here, it says a corporation is an artificial person or legal entity created by or under the authority of the laws of a state. Okay, this shit just said an artificial person. Okay, real quick, when you were born, did you get a birth certificate? Odds are you did, okay? If you got a birth certificate, let me just go ahead and tell you right now, your parents sold you out. Now, of course, it's not something they did knowingly. If they knew what was really going on, there's no way they would have actually signed that junk. But the birth certificate is basically an application into this corporation, the United States, this artificial person that is in here, okay? The corporation is an artificial entity, and they create an artificial person, aka a smaller company under the big company, right? So now they created this company with your name. They created this company with your name in all capital letters, all right? So John Doe was just born, but John Doe, his name is in all capital letters on his birth certificate. Now you gotta comprehend something. In law, anytime something is written in all capital letters, it's a fictional entity, meaning it does not actually exist. You can't touch John Doe in all capital letters. That's a dead man. Okay, you ever notice that when somebody's dead, you look on a tombstone, they put their name in capital letters. You put somebody's name in capital letters anytime that it's on any kind of bill or anything. Look at your bills. If somebody sends you a light bill, bet your name is in all capital letters. Bet your name is in all capital letters for your insurance, etc. There's a reason why. Because they are not actually demanding money from you. They're demanding money from this business entity that the United States Corporation created with your name. Now, how is this possible that they're able to do this? Okay, so there's a hell of a lot to explain. But just walk with me, because this is very important information. You're going to have to do your own research too. But I'm just giving y'all some of the sauce, because it's way too much to put in one video. Way too much to put in one video. But look, once upon a time, these founding fathers drew up this constitution, right? The constitution actually held up your rights. You actually do have the right to bear arms naturally. You don't need a permit. You also have the right to travel naturally, okay? Let's talk about travel real quick. This one of the most important things you need to be able to do in life is go where you want to go, however you want to do it. Okay, we are getting tricked into giving up our right to travel for, in exchange, privileges to do something that might be called driving, right? We don't know what driving is. We think that driving means we get in the car and go where we want to go. No, that's traveling when you get in the car and do what you want to do. What you got to recognize is there's something called driving, which only happens when you're doing it for business, or should I say for a commercial purpose, okay? So you get in the car, since you got a driver's license with this artificial entity that is probably called like the DMV or something like that. They created a business that you got a contract with. They made you sign your name on the freaking thing that's called a driver's license, right? I'm sure your signature is on it. If you got a driver's license, you have a contract with this business now. You do not need a contract to travel with anybody. You have the unalienable rights to travel. But when you unknowingly give your rights away and you do something like sign a contract, and then especially if you don't know how to endorse it properly, we don't even know how to write our signature properly. So when we write our signature, we write our signature on something, we don't reserve our rights or anything. So really, when we do something like that, we could very easily be giving away our rights and let somebody else have control over us. So contract law is something that's very, very important. And this is why this stuff is set up like this. These folks are controlling everything about us, from our money, whoever they are. If you don't even know who they are, when a conscious person talk about they, you need to go ahead and go on somewhere else if you don't know who they is, the powers that be. If you pretend like you don't understand what a smart person mean when they say they, then you got other issues. All right, so you know who they is. It's the invisible people that are controlling this shit, all right? So I'm just going to give this to you raw, because this is actually really disturbing information that you can learn and realize how we've all been bamboozled. And I'm here to put a hole in this junk. Like, obviously, if you're on this channel, it's a lot of information that you can come across in this world. Anyway, let me stay on subject. You get this contract for you to drive a car. Now you're operating in a commercial capacity for this corporation called the United States that literally owns you. Physically, they own your body, they own your blood, they quite literally own you. That's why they take your DNA, they take your fingerprints, they put the baby's ink, they dip a baby foot in ink and put it on the freaking paper. They take your fingerprints, they take your DNA and everything. Your parents don't know that when they do this, they're doing this because there's this legal stuff that, if you do enough research on it, it happened across seas during one of those plagues. So basically, when there was these great deaths happening, there was a whole bunch of deaths happening. And it was like, damn, these people figured out how to slide in there these rules that basically say, we're going to assume that everybody's dead unless they claim to be alive. So now everybody's dead on paper. They created all these fictional entities, even though we're flesh and blood people. We're quite literally here. But on paper, legally, unless we go and do the proper protocol as far as pushing the right paperwork, we're seen as dead people. We're seen as people who cannot contract with the living. The dead cannot contract with the living. You got to understand this. You got to overstand this. I keep saying understand and overstand because in law, if you go into a courtroom and they ask you, do you understand something? Basically, they're asking you, do you let this control you? Are you complying with this? Are you letting us get away with controlling what we just said you have to do? So you don't want to ever say you understand anything in law. So anyways, continuing on. They got people thinking that money is real, right? Okay, the United States Corporation went bankrupt a long time ago, okay? Let me think. Once the United States is in bankruptcy, of course you can research all the stuff that I'm talking about. The United States is in bankruptcy, which means that there is no money. The reason why their money isn't backed by gold anymore, and they trick people into turning all their gold in because they're consenting to be a part of this corporation now. When they do this, you give up a lot of your rights as a person in general whenever you consent to being a U.S. citizen. Every time you fill out an application, it say, are you a U.S. citizen? You check yes, you just sold your rights away again. You just reiterated that you do not have control over yourself. You're giving up all of your diplomatic immunity, your sovereign immunity. And I hope I'm not talking over people's heads when I use certain terms. But like I said, you got to do a lot of research and know what this stuff means. So get a law dictionary. Get a law dictionary. And just look up some words that you use every day, like citizen or residence and stuff like that. You'll realize that all these words in law mean something different than how we use them. The word drive. Anyways, so continuing on. There's this thing that happened that I could go into great detail about all the different groups that are responsible and all that stuff. I'm sure you heard of the Rothschilds, even if that's not how you really pronounce it. The Morgan Group, Rockefeller Group, anything that has to do with these people who are these wicked, evil people who wanted to be greedy and take control of money. They tricked us into thinking that money is real. Let me tell you this. Money is non-existent. So knowing that it is impossible for you to actually pay any debts, because you can't actually pay any debts, when you're doing something like signing a contract, technically you can get out of debt immediately. Like, because the United States is responsible for taking over all the people's debts and paying people's debts back whenever money is available again. Just look up House Joint Resolution 192. People do not have money anymore. Money is non-existent. They have this fiat currency that we call money, and they're tricking us into earning that for a living and then sign a contract and do something like get a mortgage, get a car note. We're thinking that we can possibly pay it off. No, bruh, you'll never pay those debts back.